Jean-Baptiste Joseph Fourier in 1824, he found himself unable to ignore a question niggling at the back of his mind, which is now the biggest issue of our time. He thought, given the Earth's distance from the sun, our temperature should be much colder, more like the moon. You know, the one he figured there must be, oh, there must be something keeping the energy from the sun trapped in. Well, in 1856, a scientist named Eunice Ford, she took the question and she threw away the book. You see, she pumped CO2 into one glass tube, filled another with water vapor, one with plain air too. Then she used the thermometer to clearly show that the ones with air and vapor were heating much more slowly than the other two filled with CO2. Oh, CO2, you take a carbon atom, some oxygen atom, 62. When they bond together, they create a sort of roof, so the temperatures on Earth are warmer than the moon. Hey, CO2, oh, CO2, things are getting totally screwed because we've released too much of you. Now the energy from the sun cannot get back through, melting permafrost, turning the oceans dark blue, causing horrifying, devastating positive feedback loops. Well, in 1896, spontaneous hypothesized, since we were releasing more CO2 into the skies by burning coal for heat and industry, we would begin to change the climate eventually. But it was assumed that the oceans would soak it all in. So for the first part of the century, no one much paid attention until 1956, when Roger Verwelle and Hans Toussaint stated, the upper layers of the oceans are pretty saturated, and so they guessed. Y'all, that means the atmosphere must be accumulating all the rest. Enter Charles Keeling, who built a CO2 monitoring station in Hawaii and turned the CO2 monitoring machines on in 1959. And 1 year later proved scientifically, indeed, CO2 was increasing atmospherically and has been rising pretty much ever since each year, more than the last, because we keep burning oil and coal and gas and factory farming and deforestation. No CO2, oh CO2, you take a carbon atom, some oxygen atom, 62. When they bond together, they create a sort of roof, so the temperatures on Earth are warmer than the moon. Hey, CO2, oh CO2, things are getting totally screwed because we've released too much of you. Now the energy from the sun cannot get back through, melting permafrost, turning the oceans dark blue, causing horrifying, devastating positive feedback loops. Well, every story needs at least one villain, someone willing to screw us all to make a killing. And luckily for humans, oh, have we got plenty of those to make this planet good and fracking hot. For example, the American Petroleum Institute was warned that burning fossil fuels led to the world being warmed. This happened in 68, which would have left time to do something. So they decided to spend millions to undermine scientists' findings and scientists' words. Though they believed what they had just heard, but the priority is, I guess, this comes as no surprise, to make money, not care about whether life on planet Earth survives. Yes, capitalistic wet dreams have kept us. Fossil fueling this greedy ride as the Arctic melts. Now they want to drill deep down, claiming their God-given right to commit terrorcide. You know, about 100 corporations are responsible for around 71% of emissions, which I'll never say, because those emissions should have been reduced. Oops, like yesterday. Cause see, the effects of CO2 have a few decades of lag, which means, well, I guess we can all do the math. Cause you see, they've decided here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna burn it all. If you don't agree, we're bombing you and buying you and invading you and suing you. We'll support your coup, any coup will do as long as you do what we tell you to. Oh, CO2, oh, CO2. You take a carbon atom, some oxygen atom, 62. When they bond together, they create a sort of roof, so the temperatures on Earth are warmer than the moon. Hey, CO2, oh, CO2. Things are getting totally screwed because we've released too much of you. Now the